So you have to be number one in Europe if you want any sort of safety net.
Yeah, listen, Ealingstat and Zico, it's really hard for you guys to hear this, but
it's been hard for us to hear it for about a month now.
It's been hard to hear.
It's
since
nice.
BlizzCon.
It's a bit of a different tune on the desk, which I
don't
know,
like. I don't think it's nice.
were we this obnoxious when Europe were winning everything?
You were.
Yes,
actually.
You were. 100%.
Definitely.
I don't know what you guys are talking about.
We're like football fans.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. 100%. Well, looks like Jamie will be the target of choice early on, and I have to say I've lost faith in Twitch chat just a little bit. I feel like you guys have been making the wrong picks here today. I feel like
careful, careful, tread carefully with Twitch chat.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Prove me wrong, or I guess Diabolus might be able to prove them wrong. Rogue Mage Druid has been so dominant in this tournament so far. They've won four series in a row.
Didn't they bet? I'm pretty sure they bet for Diabolus.
No, they bet for Zizon.
It was definitely 70-30.
Oh. Looking at the wrong side.
Just like no dragons on Blade's Edge, huh?
Look, there are dragons on Blade's Edge.
Oblivious today.
Jamie gets Ironbarked on this assault, but it was no Icy Veins, no Vendetta, so Diabolus have an opportunity here for a big punch onto Jamie. They're already still just holding his health at half. Could be an opportunity. Curious to see if Drainer can clean up the mistakes that he made earlier today. He's going to be basically playing against Rogue Mage for the rest of the tournament if his team stays alive, I think. So he's definitely got to be careful, not get caught in as many polymorphs as he was in the series earlier today against Method Black.
Yep, and Alec is going to be taking a little bit of burst damage. We've seen Mercy and Jamie. They've been able to put out a lot of burst damage on these mages, so you have to be careful. A Destruction Warlock, an Elemental Shaman, all you need is one Chaos Bolt paired with an Earthshock, and you can just instantly take someone out of the match. Nixie eating one Chaos Bolt so far. We've seen Diabolus play very, very defensive in this matchup, and that is a playstyle they've had. You know, Alec, Azeroth, they are not afraid to just sit back, stall out the game, wait till Dampening, where they have a more favored advantage with Nixie on the Assassination Rogue, able to put out good, consistent pressure. We'll have to see how they play it, and you really can't blame them. I mean, playing in the open against the Destruction Warlock Elemental Shaman is no easy task for a mage.
Drainer running around, just poking every member of the team, making sure that he's got damage on the three members. Now they're focusing down Alec, who is not running the Temporal Shield, so he won't have that to soak big burst damage. Instead, running the Kleptomania to remove heal over time effects, and most importantly, the Ghost Wolf. If they cannot get Jamie out of Ghost Wolf during crowd control on Drainer, there's almost no way they're going to kill him. In this situation, though, they're actually attacking Drainer, trying to bait some cooldowns. They get the Barkskin with this attack. They didn't use Icy Veins. They didn't use Vendetta. They could kill Drainer if they get his trinket with Blind and then swap to him again, and I'm wondering if that is going to be their strategy or if they just go for consistent swaps and maybe use Blind on a different target. That is going to be up to Nixie to decide. Currently attacking Jamie, but feared immediately on his stun. That fear timing from Mercy was perfect.
See what exactly happens. Nixie now in the midfield, still taking a little bit of damage, trying to reconnect onto Jamie. Drainer gets caught into a polymorph. Jamie has to use the Astral Shift. A little bit of a mistake there by Zizon. Have to see what they can do. There's a full blind on a Drainer. He trinkets out, and now this is a good situation for Diabolus to be in. Jamie, no Astral Shift. Drainer, no trinket. They need one good setup, but Nixie in the meantime taking a lot of damage off the back of that Lightning Lasso and a Chaos Bolt. Azeroth is caught into a Fury, managed to connect the Ironbark onto Nixie to keep him alive. Good heads-up play. Now Drainer into a Kidney Shot doesn't make a swap, but a Bear Form should be able to keep Drainer alive in the situation. With the Demonic Gateway, he does manage to cross the map, and he's going to be able to get out of danger.
He's got no Glider's Medallion, and he's got no Barkskin. They still have Icy Veins. Potentially Alec could carry the game here on the next attack. Where are they going to focus it? Right now, Jamie is just being attacked. Maybe that's a bait. They do a quick bait and switch over to Drainer. They could catch Drainer out of form. They cheap shot him instead. They need to Ring of Frost as he's in travel form. Doesn't look like it's available. That is unfortunate. Now a Fear and double Mortal Coil from Mercy easily is going to deny the kill onto Jamie. He recovers. Azeroth and Alec repositioning towards Drainer. Frozen Orb Icy Veins available at any moment. They also have Smoke Bomb. Looks like they want to potentially attack Drainer. Nixie poking him a bit, maybe putting up a Rupture, trying to prime up Drainer for a swap. They could 100-0 him with that Feral Affinity if they catch him out of Bear Farm. Nixie moves over. Looks like they still committed to Jamie. Cheap shot on Jamie makes me think they want to swap with Kidney Shot. They're going for some Gladiator's Maledicts at this point, but not actually able to connect them. Actually connecting onto Alec. Alec blinking away. I'm very surprised to not see them go into Drainer yet. Now he has Barkskin available, so killing him through Barkskin is unlikely. Alec gets bursted. Nixie gets swapped too. Nixie.
Oh, big cast.
Pulling out a big feint.
Uh-oh.
May not be enough. Cloak of Shadows at 10% is now enough for Nixie to recover, but that is the most important cooldown for the Rogue when facing the Spellcaster composition. You can't rely on that to save him now for some time, and he's still low on health.
Yep, this has been really scary for Diabolus in this matchup. Nixie, no Cloak of Shadows available. Alec and Azeroth, they've been doing a good job running away, but Nixie's just being left behind, and I think that's the main advantage that we see from Zizon, is they're able to, luckily, you know, get good pressure out onto Nixie when Alec and Azeroth are, you know, running away, and it's been great for them in this matchup to keep up pressure. Unfortunately, Drainer's mana is way behind. He's been playing really aggressive, not able to sneak away for drinks whatsoever. In this positioning, I feel like Drainer might want to try to escape, try to recover some of his mana, and they might be able to get a mana lead in this matchup and sort of chokehold Diabolus down.
Another swap to Drainer. Jamie saves him with Lightning Lasso, Shadow Fury from Mercy. Mercy's peeling is a lot more on point, I would say, here against Diabolus. The Shadow Fury's Mortal Coils and Fears have been timed perfectly to save the team, but even despite that, Drainer is at a significant mana deficit to that of Azkarath, and that could just be a main win condition with the Assassination Rogue and Dampening. It's just consistent pressure. They go after Jamie once again. Mercy peels them away. Mortal Coil into Fear. That buys time. Drainer heals up, but at the expense of his mana. And unless Drainer can get a drink, there's a significant advantage to Diabolus.
Definitely, Jamie with a Lightning Lasso over on a Nixie. One Chaos Bolt lands. Will a second. There's the stun. Chaos Bolt. Big damage on a Nixie. Iron Bark connects from Azeroth in order to keep him alive. In the meantime, Drainer, he's across the map. He wasn't, unfortunately, able to recover any of his mana. I thought he got out of combat. I thought he was able to sip, but unfortunately not able to find it. Now Jamie in a lot of trouble. He trinkets out. Drainer gets hibernated up into a cheap shot. Is there any follow-up crowd control? The Obelisk could just claim game number one. Jamie's in a lot of trouble. A lot of damage reduction available, though, with the Astral Shift, with the Iron Bark. I think Sizon's going to be able to hold on.
Sizon, but now Cyclone at low health. Can they time some crowd control on Drainer? Time some burst on Jamie? Doesn't look like it unless Drainer gets caught. He shapeshifts, avoids the poly, jumps in, stuns Nixie, stalls some damage. Alec gets bursted. Two Chaos Bolts. Surprising to not see an Ice Block just traded there purely for efficiency so they can stay on target, that being Jamie, and burn the rest of Drainer's mana, because Azkarath's mana is starting to even out. We see a blind. Drainer has to drink it. There's no way he can sit through that. Stormkeeper up. Jamie's doing a lot of damage. Alec in trouble. Jamie jumps in. He's going to respect that. Trade one Ice Block. Zizon keep themselves in the match. Mana is evening out. Cooldowns are evening out. And with Dampening stacked up, it's anyone's game.
Yeah, definitely. Diabolus just one setup away from closing out the game. Beautiful blink counterspell. Unfortunately, Nixie still in a lot of trouble. There's the Infernal Stun. Mercy still trying to get some burst damage rolling. Throws out the Mortal Coil. Nixie does manage to get out of line of sight. Frost Nova keeps Mercy in place, unable to follow up the damage whatsoever. Nixie and Alec, they need to get some damage rolling on Jamie. Zizon is just walking all over them in this matchup so far, but there's a lot of defensive cooldowns available. Drainer now in a lot of trouble. In a kitty shot, he activates the bark skin. Is it going to be enough? Jamie trying to help him, but he's caught into a bash. And there's an interrupt on Mercy.
Oh!
Finally escapes, and Nixie now eating a few Chaos Bolts. Has managed to barely hold on, but Azeroth, he has to play catch-up. Both these teams hanging on by a thread.
Hanging on by a thread, indeed. Man is totally even now at this point. Cooldowns, I would say, are maybe slightly in favor of Zizon, but they may not matter with a counterspell secured on the Drainer from Alec. Nixie is low at the same time. Chaos Bolt's being casted. Alec denies further follow-up. Cyclone full duration on Drainer, and they've used two defensive cooldowns before Vendetta. That's 3 seconds away. 3 seconds away until Jamie is almost certainly going to die. Alec is just going to Ice Block. They know they've got the game in the bag. They can just drop the Vendetta. Jamie gates to safety, but is it really that safe? Alec flurries out. Huge damage onto Jamie. As soon as Nixie connects, Jamie is just going to die. There's absolutely no way he should survive this Vendetta. He's on the run at 1%, but it is not enough. Totally tapped on mana, time, and crowd control.
Lost Druid, and so far, no one's been running it, so...
No one wants to be embarrassed.
Yeah, exactly.
As a Cloud9 dominate, if you just lose as Mage Warlock Druid, you just look stupid, basically.
I don't know about that, because in the North American side of things, we actually saw Cloud9 lose.
Jamilia's the only team that beats them. And they beat them in the spring season, too, and they were pretty close to qualifying. So I'm not actually surprised that the Mew Mew Kitty Cats are able to beat Cloud9, because they are actually the only team that consistently does. So,
as a famous turtle said, the circle of life can be cruel.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely true. We'll have to see what happens here for Diabolus? Are they going to be able to get another victory in game number two? This is the composition and the map pick for Zizon, opting to go with the exact same matchup. They're going to bring it to a smaller map. Runes of Lordaeron a little bit more difficult for Diabolus to use line of sight and escape. It's a much more wide open map with less pillars. So that's somewhere the Destruction Warlock and the Elemental Shaman sort of excel at. When we saw Zizon get a victory earlier on, they were able to take down Chaz, like Super T said, with a big one-shot on the Restoration Druid, so that could be something we see moving forward.
Ooh, Infernals have landed. Alex going to Ice Block and respect those cooldowns, not going to be going down to any sort of shenanigans, but they could immediately switch targets, and maybe it wasn't needed, and that's the tricky usage of the Ice Block, is you would like to get away with not using it, but if you miscalculate, then you die, so difficult decision to make. Alec goes for the safe one. Diabolus make a swap to Drainer, so they're initiating a similar strategy of trying to go after the healer. They get a Bark Skin for effectively free the next time they switch, or maybe they use Blind to get Glider's Medallion, one of these routes. They could kill Drainer later on, so maybe Drainer should consider repositioning to the Demonic Gateway. Jumping on Alec at this time also does bring him close to it, but he could be stunlocked. Instead, they go for a Blind on Drainer, who he anticipated because Jamie was stunned the global cooldown prior. So he activated Bark's Iron Bark, which is reducing damage on Jamie, allowing Drainer to sit this crowd control, although could backfire if he continues to sit it. No follow-up. No, there's a bash. Jamie's still low on health. Does not want to have to use Astral Shift before Vendetta. Doesn't look like he should need to, as crowd control is finally finished and Drainer gets away with the greedy decision.
Yep, Jamie taking a little bit of pressure right now in midfield on this tomb. Looks like all six members are sort of huddled up. Azeroth throwing out a Tranquility to keep his team alive, keep him aggressive. Alec has already traded out one of his Ice Blocks in the match so far, just sort of making a fair trade. Dark Soul, as well as the Infernals coming in from Mercy in this matchup, and I don't think it's a bad trade whatsoever. Doesn't want to just fall down in the opener, and that allows his team to, you know, not really fall behind. Also allows Azeroth to save some mana, and this could be a matchup where mana really plays in, especially with it being a smaller map and being difficult for these druids to really sneak away and drink. Nixie right now taking quite a bit of damage. Faint, as well as Gladiator Safeguard, is the protection he needs in order to survive. Azeroth immediately able to stop him off, but here's a big setup on a Drainer, immediately using his Bark Skin. Do they have the damage to take him down? There's the bash. Nixie, what are you going to be able to do? Ooh. Mortal Coil comes in. Azeroth is going to be chasing him down. He gets feared up. Mercy saves the day with the double Mortal Coil, the fear onto Azeroth, keeping Drainer alive.
Drainer escapes to safety. Good teamwork by Zizon to stay alive. This is an elimination best of five. Loser is out of the tournament, and it matters so much to accumulate points, as those points will qualify you to the Summer Finals, which has an opportunity to directly qualify to BlizzCon and the World Finals. And there's even more pressure added to the European region in particular, although at this time Nixie is in a bit of trouble, stunlocked around the corner. Azeroth recovers with Iron Bark, and I will go back to explaining. The Summer Finals have the direct qualification to BlizzCon, and it matters even more so for Europe because there's already a North American team going. And if a North American team wins the next Summer Finals, then only one team from Europe will go to BlizzCon overall. And that one team will only go based on points. So you need to accumulate the most amount of points if you even want to feel safe to make it to BlizzCon. And with Cloud9 in North America, it's going to be pretty tough.
Zico, hold me.
Yeah.
Honestly, Adrian, I think we're out on our own here. They won two lands, and all of a sudden, you know, they just forgot all
about
Europe.
Are you losing faith?
I don't know.
I'm never losing faith in Europe.
Huge damage. Second Ice Block from Alec. That is not good for Diabolus. I'm almost wondering if Azeroth was anticipating himself as the target, and maybe he's spending a lot of time just preempting himself for an attack, and then Zizon just focusing their damage onto the other members of the team, because both Nixie and Alec are very far behind at this point in time.
Yeah, I mean, this is danger time for Diabolus. Alec has no Ice Block for another minute and 45 seconds. Jamie taking a little bit of pressure. He has no Trinket. He has no Astral Shift. Jamie's actually really vulnerable here if they can keep up the damage. This is the Vendetta. They can keep up the damage on Jamie. A good Kleptomania spell steal from Alec. That might be what they need to close out the game. There's a full kidney shot. Immediately responded Drainer with the Iron Bark. Azeroth keeping Nixie nice and healthy as well. uses his own Iron Bark. So both druids sort of trading out the defensive cooldowns to keep their teams aggressive in this situation as we move towards 3% dampening.
Dampening has engaged and will reduce healing over time. Azgrath's crowd control. Nixie is as well. Alec is in trouble. Lightning Lasso. This is a big combo. There's not much left. He could just fall. Big Swift Mend from Azgrath, but still Mortal Coil from Mercy into a Chaos Bolt, into a second. Gets counterspelled. Good denial by Alec. Disrupting the damage there and surviving. Azgrath got some mana. Let's see what Drainer got. It's about equal at this point. A slight lead for Diabolus, but in terms of cooldowns, actually about even. So even though there has been a lot of scary moments for Diabolus, I actually give them the lead at this point in time.
Yeah. I mean, I think you're right, especially as the game goes on. Alec only has 35 seconds left. Are they going to be able to take him down before that moment? Dark Soul is available for Mercy. What is he going to be able to do? Lightning Lasso on Alec on that Shimmer. Nice counterspell. Actually, an interrupt from Nixie slows that down. So good backup. Mercy getting aggressive right now with the Dark Soul looking for a Fear. Can he find a Chaos Bolt? Looks like all three members of Diabolus are just going to be running. They know what can happen when a Chaos Bolt lands. It's very devastating. It's frustrating for Mercy with this cooldown, trying to get some damage rolling. Finds a Chaos Bolt on Alec. He's caught into a bash. He trinkets out. Still just line of sighting. And they've been running all mash. And it's difficult on this map on Ruins of Lordaeron. I really feel like Zizon, they made an intelligent decision going to this map. It's a much more difficult for Diabolus to actually run and hide. And it's been showing.
Mana is evening out. It's still anyone's match here now. Jamie being polymorphed is making me wonder what Diabolus is... plans are here. Are they going to try and kill Drainer? It looks like they want to. 2 seconds before Iron Bark? Is he really going to die? Or before Barkskin? Now maybe he dies through it. Alec and Nixie Mortal Coiled away. Mercy with perfect timing on those peels. Drainer stays alive. Barkskin for Icy Veins, but still Vendetta available. Could be an opportunity. 30 seconds on that Glider's Medallion for Drainer. They could go for a Smoke Bomb on Jamie. There's a couple of options here. He stunned Jamie, but he's too close to Drainer. No reason to even go for any damage off that. It's more of a stall tactic. Azgrath is actually now behind on mana, so this is not looking good for Diabolus, although if they can survive 60 more seconds, Alec will have two ice blocks, despite having burned two of them earlier on in the match, so basically a reset in terms of cooldowns, but it's a reset at very deep dampening. Nixie stunned up. Infernals have landed. Ooh. Mercy lines up one bolt, lines up two bolts. Could easily be a cold snap ice lock before he can get two. Alec would love to wait another 39 seconds if he can. Dropping that frozen orb and blizzard and then moving away from the fight. And this is what Alec is known for, is just dragging the fight on, avoiding his opponents as long as possible, and then finding victory with pressure points and damage. So far it's worked, but it could backfire against the Warlock Druid Shaman composition, as that's what is normally the Warlock Shaman Druid's strength.
I think that's true. Alec now getting a little bit bursted down. 13 seconds left on that ice block, and that, like you said, it's going to be a full reset. Alec faking that wind shear from Jamie. Now kidney shot on Jamie. Good backup. There's the frozen orb. Good damage. Good crowd control coming in from Diabolus. Jamie left all alone. Forced to use his astral shift. Drainer now is caught into a cyclone. Good crowd control once again coming in from Azgrath in this game. This Vendetta is rolled out as well. Jamie still just line of sighting the best he can, using the lightning lasso, looking to avoid some pressure, but with the amount of line of sighting he's doing, it's difficult for Mercy to actually get any sort of counter pressure. Sometimes you have to just stay in the open so your Destruction Warlock can get Fears out, he can get Chaos Bolts out, and that's the best defense you have. But Jamie just line of sighting a whole bunch. It's much easier for Nixie as well as Alec to just avoid that damage entirely. In the meantime, Azgrath, he's actually managed to get away and go for a drink. Alec trades out an ice block. This is something we've seen from Diabolus all day long. They're not afraid to trade out defensives if they can get some of that mana recovered. But at the exchange of basically every defensive, Nixie and Alec have available.
And Drainer is resetting as well. Unless they can stop him. Did they manage to stop Drainer from drinking? I don't believe that they did. I think the Ursula's Vortex ended up missing. Drainer's basically full mana. Complete reset here, but Jamie's behind on cooldowns. Gonna be a bit of a race to the finish here in the next couple of moments, as this game could end at any. Jamie repositioning, forcing Nixie to retreat. Alec, Nixie, Azgrath repositioning. Lightning Lasso. Mercy lines up a bolt, but can't get it. Jamie was denied. Now, though, Alec out in the open. Feared into Chaos Bolt. Good setup by Mercy. Two Chaos Bolts in a row. It's going to be quite a bit of damage. Alec blinks around the corner. Nixie is still exposed. Zizon look like they want to push and maybe get aggressive here. Mortal Coil on Azgrath. I don't really like that timing. I think that should have been used to disrupt damage. He uses it to set up crowd control on the healer instead, but they don't get any cooldowns off the back end of it. Now they won't have that to save Jamie potentially in the future.
Yep, and this is 32% dampening. Jamie's going to be in a lot of trouble. Drainer Trinkets out, uses the Iron Bark. After those cooldowns fade, look, Nixie, Vendetta, Alec, Icy Veins. Drainer has nothing to trade with those cooldowns. It's going to be up to Jamie with that Astral Shift to stay alive. Might have to cut away with Demonic Gateway as well, but things are looking really good here in game number two for Diabolus. If they can just hold on a little bit longer, get one clean setup, I think Jamie's going to easily fall.
Yeah, Diabolus looking like they're going to be able to set up match points on what we think is Zizon's best map pick. Crowd control initiated. Chain does not get dropped. And Jamie's in trouble. Vendetta is popped. The Grounding Totem's one Gladiator's Maledict. He Astral Shifts the Vendetta, but another Gladiator's Maledict is incoming. Drainer gets out of crowd control just in the nick of time, connecting a big heal towards the end of that Astral Shift. Now Infernals have landed. Mercy is going to be doing a lot of damage. He has an opportunity to carry the team. He has an opportunity to keep them alive in the lower bracket. One big Chaos Bolt. Fear gets blink blindsided by Alec, but Nixie is still low. Asgrath is struggling at 38% dampening to heal two members of the team. Double stun. Alec respects it. Ice blocking immediately. Mercy sets up a Fear, potentially a game-winning Chaos Bolt. Cloak of Shadows at the last second. Asgrath jumps in, but he runs into a Fear, runs into another. Two members are still low. Do they have any more crowd control for Asgarath? They may not even need it. They're in desperate. They're in dire straits to kill Jamie. They stunlock him. They drop the smoke bomb, but Drainer's in position to more than easily recover. Momentum is now swinging heavily in favor of Zizon. This Chaos Bolt could be the game winner. Alec blinks out of line set, but it's not enough. Drainer jumps in for the final blow, and Zizon throw that strategy completely in their favor. And you're not going for Jamie?
No.
You're going for Diabolus?
Yes.
Why?
Because I
like
the
bad guys.
That was very assertive. I like that.
Yeah, because I like them. And
but they're the bad guys.
Twitch chat voted against them, so I want to prove them all wrong. I want them to prove them all wrong. That's what I want.
You just don't want the little guy to. He's keeping the little guy down. Jamie's having a tough time. All of his points gone on his new roster. Has to make it to LAN, and you just want them to win. So Twitch chat is wrong.
Yes. I mean, when you put it that way, I definitely want them to win. All right. We'll have to see how it goes. Alec getting interrupted. And we saw in game number one, Diabolus, they played kind of a stall-based tactic, where they were just using the pillars to line of sight. And then later on in the game is when they really committed their offense onto Jamie and eventually took him down, where Drainer really just couldn't keep him alive any longer. On Ruins of Lordaeron, it was a little bit different, much more wide open space. Wasn't as easy for Alec and Nixie to run away in line of sight, so Zizon was able to get a lot of consistent damage off, a lot of pressure off in game number two. We'll have to see what the story of game number three really is.
All right, big damage on Alec here with no Iron Bark, but Nixie's there to save him. Mercy gets polymorphed away, so the two damage dealers unable to attack means that Alec is A-OK. Drainer getting crowd controlled right now by Asgarath. Jamie still the target. Mercy saving him with fears on Alec. Equally good defense here in terms of crowd control from both sides. Asgrath trying to continue some crowd control on Mercy, but now that it's over, Zizon have an opportunity to counterattack. Chaos Bolt on Lightning Lasso. Good combo. Could be an ice block. Ooh, Alec blinks through Mercy, interrupting the Chaos Bolt. Nicely done there by Alec.
Yeah, very nicely done. Good positioning, good shimmers to avoid a lot of that incoming damage from the Destruction Warlock. Now Jamie under fire, taking a little bit of pressure. Does get recovered quite easily. And Asgrath actually going for some early drinks in this matchup. Does get shut down by Jamie, but the damage is already done. Asgrath completely recovered his mana. Stormkeeper going to be cast out by Jamie as he's looking to get aggressive, looking to get some damage rolling. Who's it going to go on? What is Mercy going to do? He has the Infernals. He has the Dark Soul. Is he going to commit it? There's a full sap on Drainer. Jamie gateways across the map, but Nixie's all over him. Are they going to be able to force out the Astral Shift? I'm not exactly sure. Drainer now caught into a bash. Good crowd control from Asgrath. There's a Cyclone. Jamie could just fall. Drainer way under responding to the situation. Jamie now using the Hellstone. Still in a lot of trouble. Kleptomania comes in, but line of sight. Drainer finally out of CC with the Iron Bark. That's enough to keep him alive, but at what cost?
I mean, it cost them all of their defensive cooldowns. Mercy's trying to counter-engage with the Infernals, or at least scare them away, but they can just run and avoid these and then push back in. I feel like it's curtains for Jamie in the next 20 seconds with good cross crowd control. They actually get Nixie left behind. They stop the Chaos Bolt. It's all about stopping Chaos Bolt here during Dark Soul. Drainer jumping in. If he can stun Alec, doesn't look like he can. Demonic Gateway for Mercy to cross the map to Alec here, I think, maybe. Chaos Bolt off the Fear. Oh, actually, on Alec. Big hit. That's going to take away the entire shield that he built up on that ice barrier. Ursula's Vortex holding them back behind the pillar. Nice hibernate, although unfortunately inside of Blizzard, so Trainer will break out of its crowd controlling effect. Nixie and Alec both at about half. What's the mana situation like here? Asgrath isn't too healthy. I'm wondering where Drainer is sitting. Drainer is actually feeling a lot more comfortable here in game three. He's spending a lot of time in cat form, dealing damage, has a mana lead. And even though that was an overcommitment in terms of defensive cooldown, Zizon stabilized and now built a lead.
Yeah, well, Drainer, I mean, he's done an excellent job in the past on that Mistweaver Monk, weaving in, sort of pushing in and getting aggressive and having to play defensive. So already kind of has that aggressive melee play style for a healer. I think that's a really good transition into that Feral Affinity, and he's been doing a really good job. It seems like he's just been warming up as the tournament day has progressed, looking really good here in game number two, game number three as well. Keeping Jamie alive, Azeroth behind on mana, another little advantage that Zizon really has. Moving forward in this matchup, Lightning Lasso now onto Alec. He still has both of his ice blocks available, and Diabolus, they haven't really been able to get too much rolling outside of that one beautiful setup onto Jamie where he almost fell. Outside of that, it's been most pressure in favor for Zizon.
Yeah, definitely has been, and they could actually put Diabolus on match point and score a point for the little guy, and Twitch chat will be right, Vinruki will be wrong. Can they pull it off? There's a lot more on the line than just a couple of jokes as well, because Europe is in dire straits. They have to win the next LAN, or only one team is going to BlizzCon.
I feel like
I'm
going
to consistently bring this up just to piss off Adrian.
This next 6 weeks are going to be great, aren't they? I'm yep. looking forward to 2 months from now, though, when, you know, we have two more EU teams in the finals.
And we'll see how that goes. Nixie caught in Dual Lasso, gets interrupted there by Alec. I mean, I personally, I don't really care who wins North America, Europe. I'm just a fan of Warcraft in general. Whatever team plays better should win, and that's the stance that I'm going to take.
And that's North America.
All right. Oh, you're brutal today, man.
We're trying to pick sides here, okay? This is what it's all about. North America versus Europe in World of Warcraft has been a long-standing history, although the other regions have certainly leveled up over time, and maybe it's like we're saying EU NA, but who knows when we get to BlizzCon, because we've got Latin America, we've got China, we've got APAC, we've got the entire globe making it all the way to BlizzCon. So even though the limelight right now is on North America and Europe, those other regions could easily come out of not really nowhere, because they've been building up momentum throughout the years now at this point. So I wouldn't even be surprised to see China pull off a victory or APAC pull off a victory. Most particularly, Sagi last year impressed everybody in the competition.
Pen and paper with a very dominating performance last year, really surprising everyone. It'd be exciting to see them once again at BlizzCon if they do manage to qualify. Going back onto this game, though, triple setup coming in here from Zizon. Nicely done. Stuns out on everyone. Alec gets caught into a Shadow Fury with Nixie, still just trying to run and hide. And that's one of the things about this map and why I thought they would go here. Just like on the Grand Arena, Alec and Azeroth, they are no stranger to the pillar with that Frostmage, with the Restoration Druid. They just love throwing out the snares, throwing out the Novas, just avoiding casted damage at all, you know, cost. And later on in the game, Nixie on that Assassination Rogue is going to be able to put out significant damage. Alec gets caught into the Fear, Lightning Lasso. This could be the Ice Block. Mercy gets counterspelled. Alec had to trinket out of that Lightning Lasso, so he avoids damage from Jamie. Then he uses the Interrupt on Mercy and completely keeps himself alive, but that is at the cost of his Gladiator's Medallion.
Yeah, at the cost of an important cooldown. It's basically the same as an Ice Block, as it removes the Lightning Lasso effect, which almost guarantees it here, as Dampening has ramped up to about 12%. We need to take stock of mana. Relatively even between the druids. Take stock of cooldowns. Basically, everybody has every cooldown. So it's a total reset here with a decent amount of mana on both sides, which means either team can take it. Now, the strategy that Diabolus are known for, they won BlizzCon with, is just stall, drag the fight on. But Jamie's composition is usually considered one of the best comps at that strategy, and it backfired on Runes of Lordaeron, and it could easily backfire here on Ashamain's Fall as well. So I do think that Diabolus are actually on a bit of a clock. They've got Drainer locked down and crowd control. They deny the Cyclone with Lightning Lasso. However, they probably would have liked to have used Lightning Lasso on it. Maybe they don't care. Azeroth down at half, caught in a Mortal Coil. How much more damage can they really get? Doesn't look like enough. Nixie's going to charge forward now onto Jamie. He's been left open. There's no Lightning Lasso threat. Now it's time to try and push for those cooldowns. They get Iron Bark. Now they're looking for Astral Shift. They're actually still attacking Azeroth. Maybe they can run him over. Zizon really didn't really attack Azeroth in the last game, so maybe he's not comfortable now with being the target. If Zizon mix it up this late into the game, the teams have been playing for an extended period of time, and certainly there's going to be fatigue on both sides.
Yeah, I think fatigue could definitely be setting in. Jamie now caught into a kidney shot at 20% dampening. The last game, I think, ended at around 41% dampening, so needing that extra healing reduction in order to close out the game. Alec getting a nice little shatter combo over onto Jamie right now. Drainer with his trinket should be able to keep his team alive. In terms of mana, Drainer does have a massive lead over Azeroth as well. The question is Azeroth going to be able to sneak away and shrink? So far, it has not been easy. Alec crossing the map once again, trying to utilize the Frostmage snares and roots to keep Jamie locked down in place. 22% damping, 23. It's ramping up quite quickly. Alec still just out of line of sight, trying to avoid damage from Mercy at all costs.
All right, Alec, you've dragged it on for this long with two ice blocks in your pocket. If this doesn't work, then we can see why Zizon is so confused in their strategies, because the Lock Shaman Druid works against a Rogue Mage playing like this, potentially, but not so much against a Rogue Mage that goes all-out aggression, although Diabolus are unlikely to go for all-out aggression. They've got good crowd control here on Trainer, but Mercy looks to counter-engage. Azeroth denies that with a bash. Gets denied, though, on his Cyclone. Actually, Cyclone by Drainer.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Drainer now in the Cyclone. Jamie in trouble. Big damage. If Nixie can make his way over there. Shadow Step, reconnect. Jamie in trouble. Ironbark may not be enough. Lightning Lasso has to hold out, buying more time for Drainer to recover. They gate across midfield. Line of sight. Ducking for cover. Dampening at very high amounts that Jamie's just having he's not able to recover. Smoke Bomb available if they can ever separate the target. Jamie from Drainer. That's definitely an option to execute for a kill. There's no defense, but there's no Vendetta, there's no Icy Vein, so it's still difficult to say who's in the most trouble at this point in time. I would say that it has to be Jamie. Mana is still surprisingly even between the teams.
I would have to say that I agree with that. Jamie now with the Lightning Lasso over on a Nixie. He uses Feint in order to keep himself alive. Mercy gets interrupted, nicely done by Alex, slowing down some of that damage, especially on the Dark Soul. It's a very high value counter spell. If we look at mana once again, Azeroth hovering around 20%. Drainer, what is his mana at this point in the game? It gets very expensive to put up your heal over time effects after a big Kleptomania spell steal from Alec. Nixie caught into a fear. Mercy has been doing a really good job in this matchup, denying the kills incoming from Diabolus as well as setting up his team. But there's a full kidney shot with the bash on the Drainer. Full Cyclone. Jamie kind of left all alone. It's going to be up to Mercy to help him out, but it gets interrupted. And now Jamie is really by himself. Nixie, Alec, they're all over him. Drainer connects the Ironbark. Is it going to be enough? Overlapped with the Astral Shift, with the Gladiator Safeguard. Jamie should be able to stabilize, but literally every single cooldown was used, and Nixie has that Vendetta coming up.
This is the same situation as game number one. Jamie dies, and unless Nixie dies before it, I'm going to say. If Nixie dies right now, then they win. But if he doesn't, in like 10, 20 seconds, Jamie just dies. He literally just falls to the ground and dies. Every ability to enhance the damage of Diabolus is available, and every damage to mitigate it isn't available on the side of Zizon. Surprising to not see... Why is Nixie not just... Okay, didn't go for it on that stun. That's very surprising. Jamie now gets to escape to safety, but there's still a window.
Uh-oh.
It's slowly slipping away, actually. And Nixie doesn't have Cloak of Shadows. Maybe he was hesitant, but now Nixie is actually in equally as much trouble as Jamie. At any point, he's going to just go down. There's no defense for some time. Nixie holds out, sets up with the silence. There's the stun. Where's the Vendetta? He's going to hold out. He gets Ironbark for free. Nixie's now just going to run away, trying to avoid damage with Drainers on top of him. Mercy lines up a Chaos Bolt. Nixie takes a big hit. He Ironbarks, but it's a bit late. Doesn't seem like it matters. Swiftman was a big heal. Nixie stays alive. Vendetta still available. No Astral Shift for 18 if Nixie can get to the target. They need to strip off that Ghost Wolf as soon as possible. Jamie gets stunned.
Oh, no.
They strip off the Ghost Wolf,
and it's
on
DR
return. Big mistakes here by from Diabolus. If Jamie can hold out 4 more seconds, he'll have an answer for the Vendetta, and then maybe be able to win. This is about the dampening mark that we saw Zizon win on Runes of Lordaeron, so Diabolus potentially with a throwaway here. Credit due here for Jamie's defensive play to avoid death this long, but I'm actually thinking that Zizon take this now.
Yeah, I mean, we'll have to see. They have to survive this setup. Drainer throws out the Ironbark to keep Jamie alive. Alec forced into an ice block. This is Vendetta. Nice fear there by Mercy right out of the ice block. Alec now pushing forward. They want to get the damage rolling. Azeroth's completely out of mana. And Diabolus may have ran out of time at 46% dampening. I just don't see how they can recover in this situation. The only thing they have going for them is a strong single target damage over onto Jamie, but I don't think they have enough health to continue the pursuit. Jamie's just going to be able to use Ghost Wolf, run away, gets the Lightning Lasso over onto Alec. This could be the second Ice Block. Now, truly, there's nothing left for Diabolus.
Oh, they interrupt the Demonic Gateway that Mercy wanted to use to stop the drink, but Azgrath didn't get any mana. His entire team is dead, and this is the power of the Warlock Shaman Druid. If they make it deep into Dampening, your entire team is simply just D-E-A-D dead, and Azgrath has nothing. Drainer is walking all over him. He's doing what he can to somehow pull off a miracle. Perhaps perhaps a miracle, despite facing death.
Oh!
Right
no
here,
way!
They pull it off. They take down Jamie, but they could fall if Mercy connects a Chaos Bolt. He goes for the fear. He gets interrupted, gets silenced on the follow-up. Azgrath is channeling Tranquility. I don't think that Diabolus can really believe it. They were at death's door. Somehow hold out. I mean, they're still playing it because Drainer is at Feral Affinity, the extra damage, and Azgrath has no mana. Maybe this goes down to a 2v2.
It could.
Nixie
easily.
In a bit of trouble.
Nixie.
Mortal Coil, Chaos Bolt. No Chaos Bolt? No Soul Shards? Mercy's now Polymer. Drainer's going to solo Nixie. I actually think maybe Drainer solos Nixie. There's no Ice Blocks either. Azgrath's still healing with nothing. Drainer is still just charging forward to try and at least pull something off here against Diabolus, but their health is stabilizing. Mercy just can't get in line of sight. Dark Souls popped. If he can get a Chaos Bolt, everyone's around the corner. Drainer's just low on health, trying to make it to a target. Demonic Gateway's across. I still don't want to call it just yet because I feel like there's somehow some potential to get a kill. Just one Chaos Bolt. And Mercy's been shut down forever on it, though, so maybe not. This was beautiful denial on the Warlock by Diabolus. This definitely could have been a cross kill, but I think Drainer is going to be falling here shortly at 60% dampening.
Yeah, that's it.
Diabolus, they're going to close it out. Hard-fought battle. Actually, unbelievable that they turned it around in those final seconds.
You said during that, you're at the end of that game.
It's just that's the facts of the situation.
Last year, you were hanging out with Mimpoike. Now you're hanging out with Jamie. You're just cruel, Sid.
Yeah. I'm only cruel, not unusual.
Okay.
I was saying you were cruel.
Just making sure.
Okay.
Just throwing out a little straw man right now. Nixie moving in, getting a sap onto Mercy. What are they going to do early on? Stun onto Nixie, stun onto Alec. Good denial here from Zizon early on. Really shutting down that Rogue Mage Druid opener.
All right, good shutdown by Zizon. Very important against the Rogue Mage. No significant openings now as a result. Drainer spending a lot more time in cat form, which is a bit of a bold statement considering he's on match point, and if even one error is made, his team could lose. But at the same time, he has to take those risks. He needs to add damage to the team if he wants to find victory. Azgrath is actually already sitting down and drinking, even though he's at 99% mana. Wants to make sure any opportunity he can to regenerate, he takes, which, I mean, is smart, considering this matchup is likely to take a substantial amount of time. So min-maxing your drinks, min-maxing your mana regeneration is an important quality to make sure you don't forget.
And don't forget to recover your mana when the opportunity rises. Nixie eating two Chaos Bolts here. Lightning Lasso out of the bash. Nixie gets recovered quite quickly. There's Drainer into a kitty shot. Are they going to be able to get some damage rolling on him? This could be something that Diabolus decides to do. Go after Drainer on the early stages of the game. Jamie's really durable, difficult to take down without the added effects of dampening. So making those healer swaps, if you have Azeroth loaded up with that Feral Affinity damage, it might be something you can take advantage of in a situation like this.
Yeah, both these teams need a good finish, as in the summer season, your points completely resets. They effectively start at zero for the summer season to qualify, so this is a good opportunity to earn some big points early on. Decent damage onto Alec, now splitting some pressure to Nixie. No significant mana lead established just here yet. Good response by Azgrath with Tranquility, healing two members of the team for a very efficient amount of mana. Drainer blinded, actually sitting through it. I mean, this is not standard for a healer to usually sit through a blind, but he sees that Vendetta hasn't been committed, so maybe he's wondering if they'll switch to him if he trinkets, but the longer he waits overall, the more they fall behind. Maybe they just throw the series away. Jamie's stun locked in Smoke Bomb. Trinkets gets out.
He just fall.
Yeah,
Jamie's still getting low.
Rosales
comes in. A lot of the healing being absorbed. That's Ironbark. Astral Shift. Cyclone on Drainer. He trinkets out. No longer is he going to have a trinket available for Blind if it does rotate back up. But Jamie's still in a lot of trouble. He's trying to run. Alec uses Icy Veins. Can they find the damage to take him down? Drainer finally connecting some heals. But that's a massively greedy play by Drainer that could end up costing them this series.
Kleptomania on the overgrowth. Jamie doesn't have Hots. Drainer connects a Swift Minute. guess that's enough. Nixie's now stunned up. Stormkeeper on to Alec. Mercy's ramped up. He's got big Chaos Bolts. Who's Mercy going to go after? Polymorph for 1 second. He could get a big hit here. Alec Frostnova's him in the line of sight. Some perfect defensive play there by Alec and Azgarath, avoiding the Warlock during his scariest moment of the match. Nixie, though, was left behind, and Jamie is kind of just pummeling away with casted damage. Nixie bursted. No Cloak of Shadows. Maybe needs to be hesitant. Doesn't look like he cares. Charging forward over onto Jamie to create more pressure to get Ironbark in this exchange. Druid still equal on mana. Still anyone's game. Alec being down a block. Nixie with no Cloak of Shadows for a minute. See if Jamie can stay alive for that Astral Shift. Although he doesn't want to trade it before the Vendetta. That's usually where he'd want to space it. So it's more important that they wait for Drainer's Ironbark, which is 20 seconds away. Nixie the target. Definitely an open target. He has no Cloak of Shadows. Actually attacking Azgarath. He's got no Gladiator's Medallion. A bit of a disrespect here. Mercy goes for an all-in. Maybe they find a kill off the back of this aggressive stance. They do!
Oh!
They make it. They go all-in. They disrespect it. And Zizon are going to take it, taking us to game five.
Talk about...
I think the only thing that changes is that NA is finally winning a few tournaments.
Don't take away my confidence.
Yeah, we'll
hopefully Jamie isn't upset with me. If he wins, then he won't be. But if he loses... See, I do it fairly. It's all fact-based.
Well, you... Okay. I mean, I feel like at the beginning of the series, you were all about Jamie. You were all about the hometown hero, but the underdog story. And now you sort of changed your tune as the series has progressed. But one thing's for sure is that's
out on everything today.
Yeah, they've been doing good. Someone has to call you out. You're out of control. Jamie now into a kidney shot, taking quite a bit of burst damage very early on. Let's see how aggressive he really wants to play on this matchup. Now, the last matchup, we did see Diabolus fall. So this is their map pick. And normally, when you see a big map like Tolvaron, the double caster setup, like the Destruction Warlock Elemental Shaman will have a big advantage. But on Tolvaron, you can also just sit at one pillar the whole game. If Alec and Azgarath like pillars, this is definitely the map for them, as it does provide the biggest pillar in the game that they can use to line of sight, avoid damage, and then secure victory in a late game kill off the back of Nixie on that assassination rogue.
Seems like at around 20 to 30%, I'm not going to speak too far ahead here. Azgarath being targeted down again. Fighter's Medallion out of the way, Barkskin out of the way. Big cooldowns there, forced on the side of Diabolus from Zizon early on. But what I wanted to say was that that strategy of just extending the game backfires at a certain point. It seems like there's a moment in time in Dampening, I'd say around 23%, where maybe Jamie dies before it. I'm so surprised to actually see him die before Dampening. Multiple Gladiators Maledicts incoming. Jamie in midfield out in the open. Drainer struggling to maybe avoid Polymorph and heal Jamie at the same time. Mercy buys a moment. Alec now in trouble, being blasted. Ice block forced. Good setup here by Zizon. Getting an ice block out of the way, nice and early. Still want to explain that I feel like in the late game, it backfires. So my calculations are right here. Around 20 to 30% dampening. Jamie will be
Whoa, please, Nixie.
Just let me explain this, okay? Slow down, all right? Around 20 to 30% dampening, Jamie has to use Astral Shift before Vendetta. Nixie then has a window of opportunity to kill Jamie before it's available. And if Jamie doesn't die in that window, then he will overwhelm their team. And that's like the main point that this can end. Of course, maybe it can end before that through some good crowd control and setups, but that seems to be the main way for Zizon to find victory, aside of maybe switching to Azgarath and trying to blast him. And they have tried to do that, so we have to keep our eyes open to everything, but I'm still wondering if it's going to be around that 20-30% mark and then around the 40 to 50 for Jamie to have a comeback.
I mean, we'll definitely have to wait and see. So far, Diabolus have kind of an explosive start here, getting a lot of defensive cooldowns out of the way. And Drainer to... they're going to be able to take down Azgarath in a big setup. Mercy not really committing too much. Does manage to find one Chaos Bolt. Azgarath in some trouble. There's two. Alec trying to defend him a little bit. Gets caught into a Spellhawk. Mercy doing a really good job in this matchup, denying Alec's crowd control, his appeals, when his healer is in trouble. So excellently done by the Destruction Warlock of Mercy. But as I was saying, there's going to be a moment. It's around now, where Nixie has blind available and Drainer doesn't have his trinket. If they go for a blind play, this could be a smoke bomb into a potential blind, but a preemptive Ironbark was very nicely done on that smoke bomb, and that does deny this kill attempt. Now Drainer has his trinket rolling up for that incoming blind.
They're going after Alec and the Lightning Lasso with a Chaos Bolt. That's a big combo. Alec able to blink back to safety. Next to Azgarath and recover, fortunately holding on to an ice block. Vital defensive blind. No vendetta committed on this attempt, as it would be just responded with a Gladiator's Medallion Astral Shift. Jamie feels comfortable. Actually, pops the Astral Shift before the vendetta. Wondering who ended up making the call on that decision. Now there's an opportunity for Jamie to go down if Nixie can stay on target. Drainer is still crowd controlled. Nixie's poking Drainer now, maybe trying to open up him as a potential target. Ursula's Vortex on the wild charge. Cyclone in midfield. Nixie's trying to reconnect. Mercy is intervening with some snares. He's on diminishing return for fear, so Nixie connects. Thunderstormed away at the sun, but Shadow Step available. Vendetta, why has he not just popped it? He's holding out because Ironbark was already committed, I suppose, but I almost wonder if Jamie would have died regardless. Now there's no Ironbark, now there's no Astral Shift. There's no way to get out of the stun. Nixie does have a clear way to kill Jamie with this Vendetta. They also have Icy Veins. I would love to see Diabolus just go all in on Jamie here for the next attempt.
Yeah, I'll have to see if they decide to do that just yet. Azeroth does manage to escape to the other side of the map. He's going to be completely resetting his mana. That puts them in a really decent position. Drainer, I don't know if he's had that same luxury so far in the match. Nixie now caught into a stun. They can't leave him behind for too long. Mercy, he has his Dark Soul rolling. There's the Infernals looking for a huge Chaos Bolt. Lands one on Nixie, taking away half his health. Immediately recovered, though. Mercy now turning his attention over on Alec, who gets interrupted. One Chaos Bolt lands. Is there going to be another? No, a Shadow Meld, actually, I believe, by Alec, denying that incoming damage. I like the plays.
I feel like the Shadow Meld could have been more valuable at that moment in time. I don't think it was guaranteed to die. Maybe he could have used it on the Glider's Maledict as well later on. So maybe he regrets that decision. Sure, it's like a style move to Shadow Meld a Chaos Bolt, but I think there's actually higher value moments to be able to use it, and maybe it wasn't necessary. I'm just being overly critical, you know. Azeroth being bursted down in midfield. Drainer is actually just owning him right now in cat form. He has to use both Barkskin and Iron Bark to stabilize. Now they're going after Jamie in a big swing. They get Iron Bark before the Bash Cyclone, though. Drainer is just reading Diabolus like a book.
Yeah, definitely. I wonder if it's a good book. Have to see Jamie now taking a little bit of damage in midfield. Icy Veins really would not have to pull out too many.
Well, he's read it more than once.
Jamie now taking a little bit of damage, but that Icy Veins from Alec really didn't accomplish too much. They looked for a power play, like you said, but with his eyes on, they were able to read the situation. The preemptive Iron Bark completely denied them. And now you can see Azeroth, he's just hiding at the pillar. Alec retreating to the pillar once again. I have to give credit to Diabolus. They have been playing this map a little bit more aggressive than I really thought they would. Nixie now into the Lightning Lasso, taking some damage. Obviously, it was the right decision. Gladiator Safeguard gets traded out. He still has the Vanish, still has the Cloak of Shadows. Doesn't want to mess around too much. Mercy's getting a lot of damage out. There's a Mortal Coil into a Fear. Drainer sits the Blind into a Cheap Shot. Is there a follow-up Polymorph? Unfortunately, Ring of Frost misses there by Al. He gets interrupted anyway, so it didn't really matter. But the deny the crowd control, that's the main thing. And now Drainer can play aggressive, and he was able to hold onto his Trinket.
Yeah, Drainer could be the X-Factor here. Nice Cap Totem stun. Cataclysm on two players from Mercy. Jamie's in position. They're ready to go for an Ice Block. Big damage. No Chaos Bolts, though. Jamie's now stunned. He can't support. Fears on Nixie during the stun. Deny some pressure. Drainer moves in again, adding some extra damage to the team. Dampening now at 14%, so we're getting around that mark where Jamie's going to have to use Astral Shift before Vendetta, which then Diabolus will have a few opportunities to kill him when he doesn't have it, roughly about 10% dampening from now. I'm trying to see if I'm a fortune teller, possibly. Drainer stunlocked here. That's your job. Drainer stunlocked. Diabolus actually mixing it up, trying to go after the healer. Drainer responds appropriately.
I feel like if you have to ask if you're a fortune teller, you probably aren't, just to be completely frank.
Well, I'm not overconfident, okay?
All right, Jamie now into the kidney shot, still taking a little bit of damage. Innervate gets traded out by Drainer, trying to be efficient here, making all of his heals free of charge. Jamie gets topped up because of that, but dampening is rampening, and we are at 18% and closing on 20%. And what is the critical mark, you think, of this matchup where it's just irreparable?
Zizon wins at 50% plus. Diabolus wins at sub 50%.
All right.
Those are the, like, that's what happens. If they win, they win sub 50%. If they can't get killed before that point, I think they get overwhelmed by Zizon. So now they've got Iron Bark out of the way before Vendetta. The next attempt likely to pull Astral Shift, and then the next attempt of that needs to be a kill for the side of Diabolus. Outside of some druid swapping shenanigans, which could potentially just end the game right now, Alec caught in a double stun. Chaos Bolt Big hit onto Alec, but immediately recovered. Jamie builds pressure onto Nixie. I like the two-pronged assault, trying to force Azeroth to make a mistake in his healing management. Triple crowd control, good engagement. This is the astral ship, but it was Vendetta. Surprisingly committed. Maybe it doesn't matter. Potentially they kill him through it.
Jamie's in trouble.
He's in Ghost Wolf, Trainer Cyclone. He trinkets a Cyclone, so now blind is a win condition, although he's still just dying. Smoke Bomb, Ray of Frost, channeled, big damage. Nixie gets bashed away. Jamie on the run, barely staying alive at 10%, but he survives that big push around the 25% mark. So now there's a potential victory with blind. And then if Jamie can survive that, I think Zizon are going to take game five.
Yeah, but that's a big if. They have no defensive cooldowns left whatsoever. The next one that is available is going to be that Iron Bark in 27 seconds. Alec taking some pressure right now, down to around 50% health. But Azeroth has a lot of mana. There's the full blind. Is there a vanish? There's not, unfortunately. What's Nixie going to be able to do? Does he go for the Shadow Meld Stealth? He does. Shadow Meld Stealth, full sap on the Drainer. Jamie all alone, 28% dampening. Just using Ghost Wolf, trying to utilize these big pillars, trying to stay alive. Nixie just trying to soul him right now. Alec out of line of sight. Mercy doing a great job with the Mortal Coils into the Fears to keep Jamie alive. I think Zizon's weathered the storm. I think they did it.
One more Vendetta, and then I don't think, if Diabolus don't kill Jamie in the next Vendetta, then I think that they lose. And if they lose, you will be wrong. Okay?
They don't guarantee lose. Do you remember Ashbane's fall?
Well, they should have just been able to end it. I think if they allocated their damage onto one player as opposed to three, although it looks cool to try and get a triple kill, if they'd just been attacking the same guy for a couple of extra seconds together, that person probably just died. So if they organize their damage at that point in dampening, then I do think that they can win. If they're just unorganized and going after everyone, then maybe not. This is where they need to be looking for the Astral Shift. If they can get Astral Shift before Vendetta, they've got a game-winning moment, but Jamie's just kiting away and denying it. Now Mercy's lined up quite a bit of damage. Nixie could be in trouble. He's got no cloak. He's got to be careful. Lightning Lasso, fully channeled. Polymorph at the last second. Double Mortal Coil. Dispelled instantly. Fear now onto Nixie, setting up for a Chaos Bolt. How much damage can Mercy get out? He's got Infernals coming up soon. He could counter pressure. Mercy has switched up his pet, running to the imp. I've seen him casting it a couple games right before it ended so that he could dispel crowd control. An interesting mid-game adaptation, switching from the Fell Hunter that's used for interrupts to the imp, which can dispel magic so he can get Drainer out of polymorphs. Maybe that's the X factor they need. Nixie's in trouble. Big Chaos Bolt hit on Nixie. Another one. They've done it. Zizon have done it. Jamie was not the problem.
Wow. Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.